I'm so happy to have you here.
Thank you.
I will admit, I'm a little sad that Downton Abbey is coming to a close.
Me too.
6 years. 6 wonderful years.
6 long years, and it feels like a very long goodbye.
Yes.
We keep saying goodbye to
Well, because the show airs, what, 6 months in advance in the UK? So you've done this goodbye tour sort of there already.
Yes, so we finished in August. So, and now we're here, and we're promoting the show that's about to, you know, it's about to air here, and it just never seems to end, which is great.
And the show is very popular in the UK, even a little bit more popular here in the US.
Yeah, I think people are a bit more bonkers about the show.
Yeah, we do bonkers very well in this country.
Oh, yeah.
That's like what we pretty much invented bonkers.
Yeah, it's a different, I think, you know, the show's more, I guess, more exotic here than it is at home. You know, some people at home kind of do that thing where they're like, oh, what show are you in? That Downton Abbey? Or I've never heard of it. And you think, yes, you have.
Yeah, you've heard of it.
Yeah.
Don't be a jerk about this.
Yeah.
But is it true that I read somewhere that you created a fake character to address American fans who came up and asked if you...
Well, that's not true, actually. I never do that where I pretend I'm not, you know,
okay,
people come
gotcha.
Over and say, are you Lady Mary or Michelle Dockery? I'm never that, you know, cruel to say, you know, pretend to be someone else. But I did create this character when I was bored, you know, with a friend of mine at some point, called Brittany, who she looks just like Lady Mary Crawley. And she's a fan, so she's probably waiting outside here. Waiting to come out and, you know, it's sort of an in-joke, really.
Okay, gotcha. And so this is an intense Lady Mary fan that looks like Lady Mary.
Yeah,
that's like
the
dream right there.
And she travels the world, you know.
That's interesting you say that thing about telling people, like, you can't pretend not to be yourself when somebody, like, I remember once very early on in my time at SNL, someone came up to me at a bar and said, hey, anybody ever tell you you look like that guy on SNL? And I said, I am that guy on SNL. And he said, F*** you, and just walked away. I was like, how did this...
That happens against me. That happens all the time.
Yeah, where people think, like, you look like that person. Yeah, you're like, no.
Yeah.
You're like,
I was in a restaurant last week, and Shirley Bassey was there.
Oh, wow.
And I was like, I can't leave without at least saying, like, I'm so privileged to be, you know, standing in this restaurant, you know, under the same roof as you. So I went over and I said, such a privilege to meet you, and, you know, I'm such a fan and everything. And she was like, thank you. You look just like that Lady Mary from Downton Abbey. Well, I am. And I don't think she believed me at all.
Like that weird, like... Now, speaking of restaurants, I've heard that you... Like, sometimes people don't... It must be jarring to see Lady Mary not in, like, period clothes. Like, when you're, like, dressed, like, in modern clothes, people must be thrown.
People get upset. They don't like it. We were at the Waverly here in New York a few years ago, me and Laura Carmichael, who plays Edith, and it was Bill Hader and Leslie Mann, and they we met them outside, and I think it was Leslie Mann, and she was like, I just can't deal with this. You're wearing leather jacket, like jackets and jeans. And I was like, well, you know, this is how we dress. It'd be weird if we turned up in a, you know, on horseback.
Hello, a reservation for two of the cast of Downton Abbey.
I've arrived.
Yeah. Yeah, like Bill Hader wasn't dressed like Stefan. Like, he's allowed to dress in his street clothes.
Exactly.